Oh, it's raining outside. Hello mga ka-LiveBit, welcome back to my channel. This is a very very special episode, by the way, and I just want to announce that LiveBit 40 has now 10,000 subscribers. Yes mga ka-LiveBit, maraming salamat po sa inyong suporta and pag-subscribe sa ating channel. This is not just my channel, this is our channel mga ka-LiveBit. This episode is brought to you by Paras Catering and Events. Check out their FB page and see all the excellent customer feedback regarding their delicious food, great service, and elegant styling. You can reach them at 0917-844-4470 and look for Ms. Jubian Paras.
Naalala ko pa nung I uploaded my very first episode last January 3, 2021. Alam ko noon, ano yun eh. Kaka New Year lang, and I was thinking of a way that I could be of help to people like me, mga nasa 40s na who still wanting to continue to be fit or wanting to start being fit. That time I just turned 40. I will be turning 40 nung that month of that year. Kaya kumbaga parang it's a nice timing din na inumpisahan ko yung channel kong yun. Well, at first I was uploading very practical advices and tips on how to make the most out of your workouts, and also a little bit of information about nutrition. I also remember uploading my workouts during the pandemic, kasi nung time na yon, as you well know, nagsara lahat ng mga gyms. So pero despite that, I still wanted to continue working out, and having no gyms is not an excuse to not train. So I did bodyweight exercises, and also nagmala-MacGyver ako noon, and I used a lot of improvised equipment. Yung mga nakikita ko lang sa bahay, like yung may punching bag, water gallons, yung mga lalagyan ng tubig, ng mineral water, LPG tanks, mga ka-LiveBit, yung jugs ko, nilagyan ko ng bato and sand para maging dumbbell siya. So nakakatuwang balikan yung mga scenes na yun. And if you want to check it out, that's in season 1. So season 1, and also yung mga nauna kong shorts from season 1, very simple beginnings. Then eventually, season 2 and 3, we started discussing topics about, yun nga, nutrition and more on workouts, diba? And with my friend, Engineer, yes! Alam mo ba? Alam nyo ba, since nandun na si Engineer, nasa early stages ng channel natin, nandun na siya. And hoping we could bring him back and talk about other things. And, lagi namin sinasabi noon, Coach Erwin Nickdown!
Hali-hali, Coach Erwin.
Coach Erwin.
Talks! Sana mag-guess ka naman dito, pre. Para naman, no?
Tayo. Again, pina-plug ko ulit, Coach Erwin. Sana samahan mo na kami.
Next time. Sana kasama ulit natin si Coach Erwin. Talks! Hinihintay ka na ng channel na to.
No, sana makasama ka na dito sa channel na to, hinihintay ka namin. Ikaw ang OG. Ikaw ang original LiveBit. Ikaw ang original ka LiveBit. So yun, sana makilala ka na nila, Coach Erwin. So yun, I'm very humbled dahil I was able to interview also a lot of LiveBit inspirations. Yun, mga LiveBit inspirations like JC Santos, Sir Alan Dizon, di ba? Coach Ranel, who just recently won his IFBB pro card. So yun, very proud kasi ka-life fit natin siya and he's 47 years old. So swak na mga ka-life fit na he's a living testament na kahit he's nearing his 50s pa, di ba? He was still able to to bag that very very prestigious recognition and it's a lesson for all of us na hindi man tayo nagko-compete, di ba? Or we can be inspired to be at our best sa mga sarili nating fields sa buhay. It may be a being a father, a good provider, a good husband, a good employee, di ba? And a good citizen of our society, mga ka-life fit. So yun, we were also able to cover a lot of nice, very, very nice fitness events like MC Fit Classic. So we were able to cover that kasi I would just like to highlight that kasi that's the first ever bodybuilding competition na in-spearhead ng isang Facebook group, mga ka-life fit. Kalahin nyo yun, Facebook group lang of like-minded people, fans of bodybuilding, athletes of bodybuilding. They came up together under the leadership of Coach Mel Cantos. So they were able to put that up. Diba, kahit hindi ka official federation, bodybuilding federation, diba? Because you just have that passion for the sport of bodybuilding, kaya nangyari yun. And magkakaroon ng classic, MC Fit Classic 2 next year, mga ka-life fit. So abangan natin yun, i-cover din namin yung mga ka-life fit. Also, locally naman, on the local scope, meron din tayo mga naging events from CrossFit Cabalen, from our friends in CrossFit Cabalen, kay Coach Mai and Coach Chris. Hello po. Thank you for allowing us to feature your events, yung Battle of the North this dito lang nung nakaraan January, and yung kaka-cover lang namin din yung CrossFit Cabalen Invitationals naman. So abangan niyo yung episode na yun, mga ka-life fit. So, hindi ko matandaan lahat ng mga kinover natin for 3 years. Basta ako nakakatuwa kasi over those span of time we were able to meet a lot of very nice and encouraging and inspiring people na katulong sa ating channel and also to our viewers also. In fact, nagkaroon tayo ng mga sponsors, mga ka-life fit. Kakalain nyo yun, may mga sponsors tayo, mga ka-life fit. And I'm very grateful to them. Unang-una, sa Paras Catering Events, managed by my wife, Ms. Jubian Paras. So, since day one, nandun siya. And then para skating in events supporting our channel. Then came Ma'am Jenica. Hello ma'am. Pet Pampanga. So I recall we did an episode also featuring Pet Pampanga. Tapos after that, Waking. Yan. For everyone who's into fitness, alam niyo yung Waking and I'm proud to say that I'm a Waking ambassador. So abangan niyo yung mga upcoming events ng Waking. So we will do a special feature about them. Tapos sweat.com.ph, sweat.ph, your fitness apparel, workout apparel. So I'm also very thankful din na they gave me a promo code para naman makapagpamigay tayo ng discount for our customers. Then we have Lifestyle Fitness Gym by Ma'am Jennifer Dayag. Hello. Hello sis, kamusta na? We go way back, mga ka-life fit, nung time pa lang ni Boss Sherwin De La Resma, Sherwin's Gym. Yan. So we had this nice transition and now Lifestyle Gym na siya, Lifestyle Fitness Gym. And nakakaano, 'di ba? Pareho ang pangalan, no? Life Fit 40, Lifestyle Fitness Gym, 'di ba? So meant to be, 'di ba, mga ka-life fit. So thank you then for giving a home to Life Fit 40. Kay Ma'am Riza of the Physical Therapy Clinic, that's the official therapist of Life Fit 40. Ma'am Riza, hello po. Salamat for also allowing us to be sponsored by you. So we also did an episode on that regarding yung sa physical therapy sessions ko. Marami ba yan? Marami bang episodes about PT? And watch out for the upcoming episode about chiropractic treatment din na pinagdaanan ko, mga ka-life fit. So yun, just recently, yung ano natin, mga new sponsors natin, kay Doc Lau, Simpao Carlos. Doc! But our sponsor from him is yung Don Carlos Cafe, kasi nga, specialty cafe, hindi lang siya puro coffee, meron din siya mga protein shakes na available. So, nakakatawa din na, yun nga, they were able to sponsor Life at 40. And the most recent is yung ANA Prints from ano, Mr. Jason Bonus and kay Kumare Mary Grace Bonus. So salamat po for handling our merchandise. So marami rin tayong pamimigay ng merchandise very very soon. Alright, with this, dinami-dami na sinabi ko mga ka-LifeFit, intro pa lang yun. Yes, the main event of this episode is, since kaka 10,000 subscribers natin mga ka-LifeFit, we were fortunate enough to be invited for an interview at CLTV 36, the regional channel here in Pampanga, for their segment Top Pick, hosted by our very very good friend Mr. Jody Mercado. So nakakataba po ng puso mga ka-LifeFit, ang ganda ng timing na kaka 10,000 subscribers lang natin, tapos and here is a very very great opportunity for us to broadcast our advocacy to as much people as possible. So here in our channel Life at 40, we always say that life begins at 40, diba? So it doesn't mean that you can't pursue a healthy lifestyle or you can't pursue being fit pag 40 ka na. It's on the contrary. Kaya nga I really wanted to really feature a lot of topics, a lot of people na mga life fit inspirations for everyone na hindi magiging hindrance ang age para we could pursue the healthy lifestyle or we could exercise and train and lead fulfilled lives mga ka-LifeFit. So let's check out the interview mga ka-LifeFit and enjoy.
Being fit is a personal journey basta magkaroon lamang ng consistency at dedication sa pag-ehersisyo. Ang isa nating kabalin, Life Fitspiration ang kanyang hatid dahil sa kanyang mga content sa social media na siguradong makatutulong para simulan ang inyong fitness journey. Ngayong araw, makakasama natin ang ating ka-LifeFit na si Denmark De Solo upang magbahagi ng ilang tips at advice upang magkaroon ng healthy lifestyle. Welcome sa topic, Sir Denmark! Kamusta po kayo?
Hello po mga ka-LifeFit! Kamusta po sa mga viewers and listeners po sa CLTV 36? Isang magandang maulang araw po sa ating lahat.
Alright. Sir Denmark, katulad po ng ating mga bisita, bibigyan ko po kayo ng pagkakataon ngayon na i-greet, i-shout out, batiin lahat ng gusto nyong batiin. Kapamilya, mahal sa buhay, mga kaibigan, followers, subscribers, girlfriends, boyfriends, and sana wala kayong makalimutan na Sir Denmark dahil baka may makapanood sa inyo sa TV, sabihin eh, ba't di mo naman ako sinout out Denmark nung mapanood kita sa TV? Go ahead po, sana wala kayong makalimutan.
Hi po sa happy 10,000 subscribers po sa Life at 40 channel. Thank you po sa support and sa pag-follow and sa pag-subscribe channel po natin. I would like to say hi to my wife, Juby Ann Paras of Paras Catering and Events. Salamat sa never-ending support sa akin and sa mga pag-shoot ko, sa pag-vlog ko. Without you, I could have never have done this. And to my family, kay mama, kay papa, kay Denver, kay Chino, sa mga anak ko, si Lantis, si Leon, si Matthew, and si Kirsten, hello!
Diba? Hindi lang isa, kundi apat na ang anak ni Sir Denmark, hindi halata. Diba? And sa mga hindi ho nabanggit ni Sir Denmark, wag ho kayong mag-arala dahil nasa puso't isipan pa rin kayo ni Sir Denmark. Pero sa para catering services, ha? Baka naman, nako. Pero totoo, masarap yung luto ng para catering services. Upang lalo po nating makilala ang ating bisita, Sir Denmark, ano ho bang pinagkakabalahan nyo ngayon?
Bali, right now, my wife and I, hinahandle ho namin yung catering and events company namin, which is Press Catering and Events. And also, I'm doing vlogging for my channel. And I'm also handling my own photo video production outfit, Life Kit 40 Productions. So, maraming multitasking involved, Sir Jody.
Mark, pero feeling ko bago kayo napunta sa kung ano man ang ginagawa niya ngayon, napakarami rin. Eh, meron ho muna kayong pagsisimula. Paano ho muna nagsimula si Sir Denmark? Siya ba ay napasok sa corporate world? Siya ba ay naging ano muna? Ganito, ganyan. Paano ho ba kayo nagsimula, Sir Denmark?
Bali, actually matagal na to eh. Year 2002, doon ako nag-start. I entered the corporate world. So, nag-management training muna ako. Tapos, slowly but surely over the years, naka-capture naman ako ng mas matataas na position until such time na naging senior manager na ako for several multinational and local companies. So, buong Pilipinas na yung hinahawakan ko, mga store networks, and yun, medyo malaki na yung responsibility ko at that time. So, more than 15 years din akong nasa corporate world eh. After ko mag-graduate, talagang doon na focus ang time ko and efforts ko until such time na nagkaroon na ng opportunity to make a big leap, to move out of my comfort zone and finally help out with my wife in the family business. So totally new experience kasi sanay ako handling staff and handling store operations nationwide, tapos bigla naging entrepreneur. So malaking adjustment, pero very fulfilling kasi right at the moment yung katulong ko yung wife ko eh, and kaming dalawa yung nag-handle ng family business na minana niya sa father niya kay late Tatang June Paras.
Sir Denmark, pero ano ba yung parang masasabi mo na nag-influence or parang naging masasabi mong nagtulak sa'yo na from corporate world gawin yung ginagawa mo na ngayon? Kasi minsan matinding decision yan eh. Diba?
Yes.
Nasa comfort zone ka, tapos medyo okay naman din ang kabuhayan, pero kapag lumalabas ka na ako sa comfort zone, ano ba yung parang naging ano mo? This is it, na decision nag-lead sa'yo ngayon.
Yeah. Well, at the end of the day kasi you work for your family eh. Sila yung sila yung talaga magiging ultimate beneficiaries ng lahat ng efforts mo eh. So, might as well, tumatanda na rin ako, I'm 42 right now. So, parang I don't want to spend the rest of my years far away from my family. I want to see my children grow up and I want to be with my wife. So, it's a perfect opportunity to spend your middle-aged years eh. Kasi nga, nagkaroon ka na ng experience sa corporate world. So, it's a new chapter going into your 40s and being with your family, kasi at the end of the day, family mo naman talaga ang main reason mo why you're doing your livelihood.
And Sir Denmark, sa totoo lang, hindi naman ho kayo mukhang 42. Mukha ho kayong 24. And then, yun na nga, the rest is history. Si Sir Denmark po ngayon ay nagpo-promote ng healthy lifestyle at gumagawa po siya ng iba't ibang content upang siyempre ma-inspire po ang ating mga kababayan na subukan ang ganitong klase ng pamumuhay. Paano ba siya nagsimula dito? Yan pong aming pag-uusapan sa pagbabalik po ng programang Topic. Pero Sir Denmark, siyempre nung nag-transition ka na medyo at first, I think, paano ba, nahirapan ba muna doon sa pag-transition mo sa kung ano ka ngayon? Siyempre, you are a content creator and then nag-handle ka ng catering services and you have also a photo video company as well. Paano ba yung transition dito? Nahirapan ba, Sir Denmark?
Yes, actually, wala namang madali sa buhay. Ano? Yung talagang mga ginugusto mo talaga, yun yung talagang napapag-persevere mo. And it's definitely a huge adjustment. Pero kung gusto mo kasing magkaroon ng magandang change sa ano, sa buhay natin, 'di ba? We have to try things na hindi pa natin nagagawa before, 'di ba? So, if we stay in our comfort zone, we may never grow or we may never experience the things that are in store for us. So, kung hindi ako lumabas sa corporate world, while I am thankful and grateful for all of the people I met there, all the lessons I learned while being, you know, in the corporate world as a senior manager, dala-dala ko yun eh, baon-baon ko yun nung lumipat na ako being an entrepreneur and a businessman. Ngayon ko na-apply yung mga natutunan ko prior. So, walang madali eh, pero as you go along your journey, yung mga lessons na yun are the ones that make you strong and resilient in the situations na nahihirapan ka, yung gusto mo sumuko. Pero then again, babalik at babalikan mo pa rin yung reason bakit ka ba lumipat in the first place eh. And then that's my family.
Sir Denmark, alam ko parang ngayon eh, ini-espouse mo na, isinusulong mo ang healthy lifestyle. Paano ba ito naipanganak? Bakit ito ang naisipan mo na maging advocacy ngayon?
Yes, kasi nga, like what I said, I'm 42 right now, di ba? And a lot of people are asking me na, yun nga, parang like what you observed, na hindi nga sinasabi nila na I don't look 40 eh. Yun nga daw. Pero kasi you have to, ano eh, you have to have a purpose in life na yun yung magdadrive sa'yo na kung ano yung mga gagawin mo, kung ano yung mga magiging decisions mo. It all revolves on that purpose. And yung I feel na yung advocacy ko na we need to live life to the fullest, di ba? And how can we live life to the fullest kung may sakit tayo or kung meron tayong injuries or kung meron tayong iniindang ano mga sakit here and there, di ba? So the only way we could go around that is to really start exercising, eating healthy, and practically living a healthy lifestyle. A lot of us kasi get into ano eh na ay, matanda na ako, hindi na ako pwede mag-exercise, or I'm too old for that. Actually, I know a lot of life inspirations out there na they're defying their age. Kahit nasa middle ages na sila, they're still able to accomplish and do things that young people ano normally can do. So, in order to enjoy life and really you know, live life to the fullest, we need to really value our health. Dahil, sabi nga, kahit cliche na to, health is wealth, di ba? Medyo gasgas na yung line na yon. Pero it still holds very true up to this time. Kahit gasgas na yon, it still holds ano timely significance for everyone.
Okay. Sir Denmark, and I think naita-translate ngayon, no? Itong sinusulo mong healthy lifestyle sa mga ginagawa mong content. And saan ba makikita yung mga content mo at anong laman ng mga content? Ito ba yung mga exercise? Ito ba yung mga words of encouragement, Sir Denmark?
Mm-hmm. Well, yung content ko really is, ano eh, it's not really that complicated. It's really straight to the point eh. Yung mga best practices, yung mga tips and advices regarding nutrition, regarding workout, so meron yun sa mga videos ko. I also interview people who can also inspire others, like ano nga yan, sina yung mga celebrities na hindi nila na realize na ano, kahit sila they're living the healthy lifestyle, like JC Santos, who is a father of a beautiful young girl. Tapos si Sir Alan Dison, a multi-awarded actor, pero kahit busy siya sa schedule niya sa mga shoots niya, he still finds time to ano to be healthy and ano spend that quality time with his children. So hindi parang kung sila nagagawa nila yon, mga artista na sila, di ba? And what more tayo na we have the time, we have the means, di ba? So fitness is really for everyone. It's not limited to certain persons, di ba? Anyone can enjoy the benefits of living a healthy lifestyle. It's just getting that decision to start and don't ano, hindi mag-delay, kumbaga. Fitness is for everyone. Kung if you want to be fit, then go out there and ano and move.
Okay. Pero siyempre alam niyo kasi Sir Denmark, no, minsan yung mga kababayan natin exercise kasi yan eh, puro buhat, puro gym. Pero it's more than going to the gym, no? It's more than the exercise ba? Meron din bang side of nutrition? Meron ding side of drive din, no? Parang meron ding of course, may mental health yung pagsusulong ng being fit in this age of your natin na 40 and above.
Yes. Actually, a lot of people they kind of parang mistake the concept of being fit na ay para lang sa mga ano yan, para lang sa mga nagko-contest yan, para lang naman sa mga basbata yan. Actually, being fit is for any age. And it's not limited to working out in the gym. You can actually run, you can actually do jump ropes, you can walk, you can jog. As long as your body is moving and not staying in one place, like sitting o kaya all day nanonood ng Netflix or couch potato ka lang, as long as the body is moving, it's still an exercise. It's still considered an exercise kasi our bodies were meant to move and not just stay put. So the moment that you're using your body to always move, and that's some level of exercise then. And if you do it consistently, studies show na kahit minimal na lang, kahit minimal movements lang on a consistent basis, may effect yun long term sa mga katawan natin as we grow older. So let's not underestimate the power of moving around. Yung tipong magigising ka lang na umaga, you take a 5-minute walk outside, that's a huge thing na magbe-benefit ka na nun along the way. So a lot of people, I just want to emphasize din na yung concept ng, kasi social media also has given us parang parang image of a fit person na kailangan ito, may abs siya, kailangan yung muscles niya talaga nakikita. But actually, being fit and healthy doesn't require you to have bulging muscles eh. As long as you're functional with your movements, your movements are not impeded by lingering injuries and you are able to do the things you want to do, na buhatin mo yung anak mo, kuya kung lolo ka, kaya mong kargahin yung mga apo nyo, di ba? You can walk with your children, di ba? Yung mga ganong simple things that you're able to do dahil you're fit, di ba? That's living life. That's living a healthy, fulfilled life, Sir Jody.
And I think, alam niyo po, si Sir Denmark kasi siya ay kuya ng aking kaibigan na si Professor John Denver De Solo. So, nakikita ko hutong si Sir Denmark noon. Payat lang yan si Sir Denmark.
Yes.
And alam ko, one time na siya ay medyo katulad ko rin mahilig sa extra rice at sa, siyempre, Kapampangan, masarap kumain. Pero he decided to be a fitspiration, magsulong ng healthy lifestyle. And Sir Denmark, as a last message sa ating mga viewers, siyempre, marami ang, nasasabi mo lang yan kasi may means ka, may pambayad ka, may pera ka, ganyan. Or ganito lang naman kami, gusto rin namin yan, kaya lang hindi kami sikat, wala kaming kakayanan. Ano ang gusto mong sabihin dun sa mga kababayan natin na gustong gawin ito, pero parang sinasabing mayroong mga pagsubok or mga challenges sa kanilang buhay, kaya hindi na nila ito naisasagawa, itong pagkakaroon ng healthy lifestyle?
Yes. Actually, maganda nga na to, no? Good question, kasi this is gonna be a prelude to a documentary that I'm gonna shoot. It's specifically about that, yung fitness challenges for persons. Kasi nga, akala nila, pag sinabing going to the gym or being fit, it's limited to a few number of people. Whereas in fact, I'm really advocating na fitness is for everyone, regardless of ethnicity, regardless of stature, livelihood means, diba? Of gender. It's really for everyone. It's just a personal decision that okay, I want to live healthy, then I'm gonna do something about it. Whether it's about exercise, it's about eating right, diba? And or a combination of both, ano, both aspects. One should not be ano eh, hindi tayo dapat limited sa ay ito lang ang nakakaya ko eh, o kaya hindi ko kakayang bilhin ng mga ganyang ano, mga ganyang mamahaling na organic food, or hindi ko afford na mag ano, kaya mag meal prep, di ba? So there are a lot of creative and innovative ways on how we can reach our goals in nutrition and working out without really spending so much. Ako nga nung pandemic, as you well know, di ba, nagsara lahat ng mga gym nung pandemic, and wala akong means to work out. So I resorted to bodyweight exercises, and I used improvised equipment para lang makapag-workout, kasi I really wanted to ano, to ayaw kong mapabayaan yung condition ko noon. So I used water gallons, I used LPG tanks, di ba, bilang mga barbell. So you just have to be ganun eh, unang-una dapat nandun yung drive na you have to decide for yourself na okay, I'm gonna try to live fit and ano, live a healthy life. All the other challenges will come along the way, and you just have to have that drive. And also a good tip, also surround yourself with like-minded people, because I was so fortunate enough to be with a circle of people who share the same passion as me, diba? So maganda rin yun na you have other people supporting you and give you moral support. So I just want to shout out my wife, Miss Jovian Paras, kasi she's been there for me since day one, since I came back from my surgery, and ano, yun nga, I decided to go back lifting and ano, and do training. Maganda yung work. It's ano, it's indispensable yung support na binibigay ng partner nyo or ng circle of friends nyo to reach your own personal goal of being healthy.
Okay. Sir Denmark, saan ka kaya pwedeng ma-access ang ating mga viewers? Meron ka bang Facebook page? Ano ba yung ating YouTube channel na pwedeng mapanood ang iyong mga social media content?
Yes, sa mga ka-lifeit natin out there, you can reach me at our YouTube channel, LifeFit 40, ayan po, nasa t-shirt na, nasa merchandise. LifeFit 40 for YouTube and also Facebook, same name din, LifeFit 40. So, yan, you can message me there, you can, kung meron kayong question or inquiry on how to start, kasi yan ang mahirap eh, how to start. Yan ang biggest hurdle for any person that wants to live a healthy lifestyle. Ako, I'm so happy na along the way, 3 years na yung channel ko, I'm able to help other people to start on their own journeys, and just knowing that na I can make a difference sa buhay nila, that alone is really ano, such a fulfillment for what I'm doing right now. And like what I said kanina, yung purpose. There's purpose on this.
So there you have it, mga ka-LifeFit. Again, I just want to say thank you to all our subscribers and supporters. Maraming salamat po for making this channel successful as it is, di ba? Kahit simple lang, kahit ano, I may not have 100,000 subscribers or a million subscribers, I just want to say my appreciation for all those who subscribed, and I just want to celebrate this momentous event, di ba? Sabi nga, yung mga things na sineselebrate, those are the things that stay with you, di ba? So, kahit simpleng bagay lang, learn to celebrate it, di ba? And be grateful about it. So, thank you to our sponsors, to my family and friends who's been there for me since day one. Maraming salamat. Rest assured that magkakaroon pa tayo ng maraming episodes pa na that will feature a lot of more life inspirations, more events, more activities na ano, that will ano, inspire us and encourage us to ano, to lead healthy and active lifestyles, mga ka-LifeFit. So again, for more features and for more content like this, mga ka-LifeFit, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel and Facebook page, LifeFit40. Hit the bell button so you'll be notified for all future content. Again, a huge shout out to all our sponsors. Check them out. Their links are in the description down below. So, we will be seeing you on the next episode. Stay safe always, mga ka-LifeFit.
Sa inyong mga fitness and nutrition videos.